Hey everybody, so I'm filming my January favorites super early. It's like a week early, and you guys are gonna be like, Sam, it's not the end of January yet. What are you doing? Well, I go back to school on the 24th, so I don't wanna have to rush this video if I get really busy with school or anything like that. I just wanna film it for you guys and, you know, get it up and not have to worry about it too much, not have to stress that I forgot to do my January favorites or anything like that. And you guys know I love favorite videos. So I'm just gonna start off with skincare. I've mentioned this product before, it's by The Face Shop. It's their Night Spot Eraser. It's just a squeeze tube, and it's actually a really thick cream, and it just looks like that. What I do is I apply this on my skin right before my nighttime moisturizer, sometimes after my nighttime moisturizer, it just depends on how I'm feeling. I put it on any dark spots I have on my face from old acne when I was like 13. And this claims to be a gentle whitening spot treater, and I heard about this through a blogger, and I bought it from eBay, and I'll put the eBay link in the box. If you guys want it, you might want to order it now because it takes like 3 weeks or so, maybe four, to get to the US, which kind of sucks, but you have to be patient unless you live near a face shop, which I think is in like New York, because there's only two of them in the US. It's really hard for me to get my hands on stuff. Well, with all whitening products, it takes a while to see results, so you can't expect this to help your spots right away overnight, but I have been using this consistently for maybe 2 to 3 weeks, and I'm starting to see a lot of results. I just have this little spot on my nose, which is a faint spot, but I got it from like one pimple one night and it disappeared. And now I'm seeing a lot of results on all the spots that are usually on my cheeks, which is cool. And it took a while for the results, like I said, but I think it's really gonna help in the long run. So I really love this stuff. I've also been using my Cetaphil moisturizing lotion a lot this month because my hands are getting really dry. And a lot of you guys ask me if I use anything on my hands. I wouldn't say this is what makes my hands nice. I just started using it. I don't use it consistently either. I don't usually wear a lot of lotion. I get lazy and I forget. But I just keep this out and I just pump a little bit into my hand. Moisturize it when it feels really rough and gross. So that's great because it's really affordable. I don't know if this really counts as skincare, but I'll put it in here anyway. It's by CarMax and it's their Moisture Plus Sticks. And I love these things. These are like the best. And it's basically just CarMax and it's clear and it's in a twisty tube. They also have a tinted one, which I'm wearing right now. It's like a sheer lip color. It looks really dark in the tube, but it's really not that dark. My lips are just naturally dark. But the clear ones are just the regular CarMax formula and it just twists and it's super moisturizing, which I love, and it's so cute and easy to carry. So I use it all the time on my lips because they get dry really easily. So this little guy is like my best friend. And it's nice and smooth and creamy. It's the best. Next, into the makeup. I did a very long review on my Maybelline Fit Me collection. And I've been using the powder a lot. And I actually like it a lot, so go check out that review. But I thought it should be featured on my favorites because I've been using it almost every day. The next thing was probably on my favorites video last year, and it hasn't been featured since. And I just started grabbing again. L'Oreal Studio Secrets Magic Perfecting Base. And it's like an unhygienic tube thing. I use like a clean end of a brush to get it out. Now because I use so much of it. But it's just like a nice moussey formula. It just primes your face so nicely. It just makes it so nice and smooth. It erases any little lines you have. It even makes your fingers feel really smooth after you use it. So I'd apply that all over my face when I remember to. I've also been using this Maybelline Mineral Power Concealer in Sand. It's just a doe foot applicator. Nothing super special about the packaging. It's like the size of a MAC lip glass. It's nice, creamy, and opaque, and it's consistent. And I'm wearing it under my eyes right now. This blends out super nicely. I think it's my new favorite drugstore concealer. I think it jumped in front of the Maybelline Age Rewind just a little bit. Two other makeup items, which I'm sure you guys have seen in all my tutorials of this month, which I'm sorry about if I use it too much. Stila Jaw Eyeliner in Topaz, which is the nude eyeliner I'm wearing on my waterline. Looks like this, and it's super creamy. Creamy. I don't own any of the other Stila Jaw eyeliners. I heard the black one smudges a lot. But because this is the nude one, it doesn't really go anywhere, and you can't really see where it goes. It just fades, so you might have to reapply it. But aside from that, I really like it. It brightens my eyes a bit and it makes them look a little bigger, I guess. It's just a really flattering shade. It makes like neutrals pop a little bit. I've had this for a long time and when I first got it, I had no clue what to do with it because every time I applied it, I made like a huge mess and it looked horrible and I just didn't like how it looks. But I do advise if you're gonna wear this, then don't forget to put a little bit of mascara on your lower lash line just to balance out how pink and nudish it looks. The other thing is my favorite liquid eyeliner now, and it has a lot of hype behind it because everyone loves it. It's by Dolly Wink, and it's their black pen liquid liner, and it has like the thinnest tip ever. I bought this online because most Dolly Wink things are either in like selective Asian supermarkets, which none in my area have it, or just online in general. It's the best liquid eyeliner ever. It's so creamy and you can be so precise with it. It's just like, let's see if I can write my name. Really nice. It's consistently opaque and I think I just wasted a lot of it, but who cares. And I'm wearing it on my upper lash line right now. It doesn't dry out. I store it upside down just to make sure it doesn't dry out. And it dries super fast and it doesn't go anywhere. It doesn't have chip off or run off when my eyes are watering or anything like that. It's just really nice, strong, and easy to use. So I love this liquid liner. I'll link it off in the box with everything else. My next favorite is also a new favorite, and it's by Sonia Kashuk. It's their Glam Eyelashes. It comes in this kit in a cool little clear box. I'm wearing them right now. I love how they give this really open eye effect, and they're super long. It's very noticeable that you're wearing lashes with these on, but I really like them. A lot of people love these. I think it's just how they matched up the longer, spikier pieces to the shorter, wispier pieces. I don't ever use the glue that comes with most lashes. I just stick with my Dolly Wink glue. So freaking pretty. I will advise you that these have really stiff bands, so they get a little tricky to apply. You have to kind of work with them a bit. But aside from that, they're really nice. Another thing that I'm loving is this brush by Crown Brush. Candy Johnson always uses this, and I'll link it off in the box. I forgot what number it was. But I use it just like for my blush or my contour because it just fits really nicely. It's actually like a flat brush. I thought it was going to be angled a bit, but it's flat, and I just use one side of it just to chisel into my cheek area. It's super fluffy. It's really affordable. Just a nice brush. I guess you could use this to apply foundation too, but I think it just works really well with blush and contour. It just works really well with powders in general. And the last thing I talked about in this makeup tutorial that I'm wearing right now is the polish that I'm wearing on my nails, and it's the OPI Black Shatter Polish. I know a couple people got their hands on it. Ulta doesn't have it till the 23rd of this month, and select stores won't have it till probably the end of the month, but you might be able to find it if you just call them up and ask if they have the Katy Perry, Serena Williams OPI collection in yet. It's just the coolest polish ever because it has some sort of paint thinner or chemical in it that makes it do this cracking effect after you paint just one coat on it. And it's a top coat too, so it just dries perfectly and it doesn't chip or anything like that. It dries super fast too. This is what my nails look like. I kind of just painted it directly on and does the cracking effect. I was wearing NYC's Wing It Wine before I just painted them completely because I was just so excited to get it. And it's the typical price for OPI polish. I really like it, and everyone is so excited to get it. So when you see one, snatch it because it's going to be super popular, and I won't be surprised if it sells out. I'll probably be wearing it a lot, but I'm going to try not to because I know a lot of other people are going to be wearing it a lot. But it's just like the perfect cracking effect. I love it. So quick. That was my January favorites, put up early and all that. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you guys, as always, for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in a later video.